I'm here with Jay, who's just won the Cosplay Masquerade on Sunday in Manchester. How'd you feel?
Pretty good, pretty hot.
Hard to die. Yeah, I can imagine it's quite warm.
Oh, a little bit. It is insulation foam going off, so.
Ooh. How long did it take to make that?
A few months. They usually start after Christmas. It's usually done by early summer.
Right.
That's with all the like, bits and bobs going on, though.
Yeah, the detail is good, all the writing on it. Don't know if it shows on camera, but we've got all the writing, everything. It's really good. So it's as well as part-time job or
part-time full-time job? Yeah. Work in the dreaded PPI sector.
Oh, one of them with all the adverts.
As an advertiser.
No.
Fortunately.
How long have you been cosplaying then?
I think it's about 5 years now, give or take. I did do a cosplay when I was 15. It wasn't very good, and the shoulder pads were actually IKEA foam shelves that were, it was like space hopper looking things. Yeah, it wasn't the greatest.
Well, everyone starts somewhere, don't they?
Yeah, that was 11 years ago now.
Whoa. I spoke to someone yesterday who used yoga mats from Palma as part of their armour.
Yeah.
Debbie. She played the. World of Warcraft. That's the one, Death Knight, World of Warcraft. And that was really detailed again.
That one was absolutely amazing.
Yeah. But some of the time that she put into that was immense. What's going on? What's going to play? I hate that one. My brain just fought. What else have you cosplayed as up to this point?
Most of the cosplays have been Warcraft based. So I've done a Demon Hunter. I did the Lich King. That was my first major cosplay.
Nice.
And then this one. And I'm hoping to do my own Death Knight this summer.
All right. You've got the hype for it.
Certainly, yeah.
But, so that's your next plan for summer? This summer?
This summer.
Right, so you're taking this guy to London, or is the Lich King
next? This one's probably going to be retired. It's pretty, it's done its time.
It's done its fair time, that's fair enough. So have you got any tips for anybody wanting to get into cosplay?
Probably say the hardest part is just getting in and doing it. You need to sort of just take the first step, buy some materials, and just do it.
Yeah.
You can spend so much time languishing planning, but the first step is to actually, you know, put a tilt to the foam and start.
Get on with it. So you make it all your own?
Aye.
So we've spoke to a couple of people that have bought it in or hybrid of mix and buy, but it's nice to see that it's such a friendly community, the cosplayers, isn't it?
It's absolutely amazing. Some of the people in it are absolute legends. There's a dude at another convention who cosplayed as the cosplay repairman, ran around in a cosplay of a repairman with a suitcase full of repair tools. He's a legend.
Excellent. Were they all? Did they all get used?
A lot of them did. Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Duct tape and glue.
Whatever works.
Works for spaceships. It works for cosplay.
Yeah. One of the things we mentioned to Jess, because we had a chat to her yesterday, is the. The stigma is finally going over anxiety and mental health awareness.
It can be difficult.
Yeah. And it's what I've found is we've spoken to a few people who are, you speak to them as the character, they're fine. As soon as you start talking about, do you want to go on camera, they suddenly go really into themselves. So do you think that if you're shy, suffer from anxiety and things like that, and you want to get into cosplay, it can help.
Absolutely. I definitely agree that it can help with sort of anxiety problems and maybe self-image issues. And the community is very supportive, so I think that's a part of it as well, is that you go in and suddenly, you know, you're surrounding yourself with people that are into the same sort of thing as you, that are into the same crafting things as you. And before you know it, you know everybody knows you, and things are pretty, just, you know, really mellow. It makes it easier.
Yeah. Nice and chilled atmosphere. Alright, I think that's all we've got time for. One last question. What's your favourite dinosaur?
Oh, King of the Tyrant Lizards. Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Tyrannosaurus Rex. That's tie-in with Velociraptor now.
That'd be Jurassic Park's fault.
Alright mate, I'd shake your hand, but you've got a massive great sword in your hand, so.
At the end of the sword.
Congratulations again on winning, mate. Good luck in London.
Thank you.
Cheers, mate. See you later.